Hey guys, well I'm a little excited right now. I've created something really special for the Line 6 Helix. I've been trying for the longest time to figure out how to create or simulate a 3-channel amp, okay? And I've come up with these couple of patches, and now it simulates a 3-channel amp, so you can go from very clean to a slight crunch to a gain, and both the clean and the gain settings both have their own lead boost. And there's a lot to this patch. It took me hours to figure out how to do this. When you look at it, there's a lot going on under the hood. There's several controller parameters going on with all these switches. It's pretty deep if I try to explain to you everything that's going on with all of these patches, it would just, I'd probably lose my place. That's how much time it took me to create this stuff. But anyway, so I've got these couple of ones. The first one is my 3-channel amp simulation. I can stay on, for one of the bands I play in, I could stay on this patch all night long and cover everything from, you know, Cameo, for example, all the way up to Journey or AC/DC. And we do all that kind of stuff in this one cover band I play in. And so this patch was perfect for something like that. It has a lot of other standard effects like phase, tremolo, you know, chorus, delay, and all that. So I'm going to go through all of the blocks and show you everything, what each button does. And I'm going to also play a little bit of it for you so you can hear how they sound. The second one I've done for you ambient fans out there. I've had a lot of people ask me, you know, man, can you create some Hillsong type of sounds? I think I've got something really good. It's based on my 3-channel amp patch, but it's not as much gain, okay? You still got your same clean. You have a slight breakup, and then you have a little bit of a drive channel, and those are your 3 channels. But the ambient stuff in this is really cool. I'm gonna demonstrate that for you. So let's take a quick look at all of the settings in each one of these patches. I can kind of explain to you what's going on here. So let's take a look at that. Guys, one thing I forgot to add, when you're using these patches, there is absolutely no latency, zero latency, okay? When you're in the 3-channel amp patch, you switch between those channels and all of the effects and everything, it's seamless, okay? That's why I had to create this, because I needed the option of being able to change channels, but there's so much latency from going from patch to patch, even when you have hardly anything in the patch, okay? 20 millisecond latency, that's not bad, I can live with that, but it's a lot more than that when you start adding all of this stuff. And I understand the CPU, the DSP's gotta, the CPU or whatever's gotta have a chance to reload all of this stuff. I understand that. I hope Line 6 is going to fix this in the future. But for now, this is what I've had to do. So again, when I'm going to be switching these things, you'll hear zero latency. It's pretty cool. Okay, so here's my 3-channel amp simulation patch. What you have available to you is a clean channel, then you've got a crunch channel, and then you've got a gain channel. Now, when you're on the clean channel, this clean channel will stay on all the time. But when you switch to the gain, I have an AB split here, and what it does is it mutes this whole chain right here, okay? So the amp's still on, but you're not hearing it. It's gonna switch to a Marshall 2204, which is a JCM 800 I have right here. Now, you can use the crunch with the gain channel or without. It doesn't matter, you can leave it on. In other words, if you're in a clean setting, you want to go to the crunch, and then you want to switch to the gain, you can leave this crunch on, and it won't affect the gain channel that much. You can barely hear that it's on. Now, on the clean channel, it has its own clean boost right here, and that's doing several things at one time. It's raising the level of the delay I have up here. It's raising the level of the compressor and a couple of other things and also a volume boost, okay? About a 4.5 dB volume boost, okay? Now, this lead boost, that's for the gain channel. If you're on a gain channel, you want to play a lead, you hit this one. And that'll do the same thing. It'll turn up the delay. It'll give you a more mids, focused mids. And so you'll cut through the mix, and then it'll also shave off some of that very high end, so you won't have any of that ice picky sound when you go way up on the neck. Okay, so that's the lead boost. On the top row, you have a modulation delay, chorus, a tremolo, phaser, and a univibe. Now, there's a lot of other stuff in here that's not on switches, but they all work in conjunction with each other. So I'm gonna play a few rips with this particular patch to let you hear how it sounds. Okay, this one here is my ambient amp. Okay, it's got the same three channels, but not nearly the amount of gain. All right, so you have your clean channel, your crunch channel, your gain channel. You've got your clean boost, again, for the clean channel, and you've got your lead boost for the gain channel, okay? Now, this is the ambience on and off button. When you press this button, when it's on, it's got an octoverb, it's got a hall reverb, it's got another kind of verb, let's see, what is that? Particle verb. Okay, and it's also got this mod delay will stay on all the time, but this is something really cool. When you're on the clean channel and when you press the gain, it will turn the mod delay lower so it doesn't envelope your sound. Okay, again, you got phaser, tremolo, chorus, and so this ambience button, when you press that, that's going to give you all of that ambient sound with delay and reverb, and you can do some incredible swells with this thing, and I'm going to demonstrate that for you. So let's take a look, just to give you an example of what's in here. You've got a compressor, you've got that's the phaser, you've got a wah, that's the tremolo, you've got a that's the crunch right here. Okay, this is the clean amp. Then you've got an EQ right after the clean amp. Then you've got a delay for the clean amp. That, as you can see, when you press the gain, it shuts that delay off. Okay, then you've got this is the octoverb here, and then on this channel, when you press the gain channel, watch these come on here. See that? That's an EQ. That's the amp. This is a cab. Both of these amps are sharing this one cab. I'm not using an amp and cab here. These are just amps. I found that it's a lot easier on your DSP if you don't use amp and cab. If you want to use more than one amp, use just the amps and you can share a cab, okay? Right here is my volume pedal. Then I've got delay, another delay. This is my chorus. You'll notice how it's at the end of the chain, so it can really widen the sound. It's a stereo chorus. It's the Trinity chorus I like. And here's another reverb. reverb, and here's another EQ pedal that has to do with the lead boost. You can see these two come on when you press the lead boost. That's the EQ that shaves off the high end, focuses the mids again, and it gives you some more delay. So that's what's going on in this one. Now let's hear what this one sounds like. Thank you.